Hi, it's Lori Ballen in Las Vegas with 365 days of KW Command. Today I'm going to show you how to make a smart plan that can be used as a check-in. Now, at the time I'm making this video is when the world is going through the COVID-19 coronavirus crisis. And everybody's at home, and so I suggested that we create some sort of a smart plan that is a really easy basic check-in. So I'm going to show you how we do this. Now you can elaborate, you can do whatever you want with it, but at least I want to show you the basics of how to do it. All right, so we're going to go over here to the left and we're going to go to smart plans. We're going to click create new and you're going to name it. This is for your eyes only. So I literally could put COVID-19 if that's what I want to this one to be, or crisis check-in, or whatever you want it to be. Okay, and then I'm going to click apply and we're going to start a new smart plan. Now, here's what I want to caution you about. I'm getting a ton of Facebook messages that are generic check-ins or emails or videos like documents. I'm not opening any of that. I'm just completely ignoring that. It's too much and it feels impersonal. So I want to caution you about going too far with this or having it feel canned or cheesy. You know what I mean? Like, that's what I want to really be careful. So I will tell you what I respond to is if somebody messages me and says, "Hey, I was just thinking about you. How are things going right now?" I got a text the other night from somebody that said that, and whether or not it was a bulk text or not, I don't know, but I answered him. So, but you can tell. So, you know, some people can, not everybody can. I'm probably more in tune to it than other people are, but let me show you how to do this. All right. So you're going to decide what it is that you want to do. Do you want to send an automated text? Do you want to send an automated email? Do you want to assign a task to make a call? Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and do all three pieces, and then I'll show you what my concept is, okay? So the first action I'm going to do is going to be a text message. So let's go ahead and send an SMS. So just click it, and it'll drop in as your day one. Now here's what you need to know. You have to have your Twilio account activated to send an automated text. Twilio is not free. It's very inexpensive, but it's not free. So you will need to go set that up. I've got videos on all how to set that up as well. And you'll buy a phone number. Now, if you want the local number and you're having a hard time getting the local number to show up, you might have to contact Turbo Dial to assign that rather than have that Austin prefix that is showing up. Jeff also did a video on that, on how to set that up. He's over at Ballen Brands. In fact, if you need any help with any of this, you can actually hire my brothers, Jeff and Paul at Ballen Brands. They build all this out. They set up your integrations. They build your websites, whatever you need. Ballen Brands. Okay. So now you can choose, do you want this message to be, let's just stick with the basics right now. Let's just leave it as a static message. And we're going to go to the text message. So this is what is going to send to them. As soon as you add them to this smart plan, they will get this text. So be careful. If you're creating this at 2 o'clock in the morning and you add them, they're going to get the text at 2 o'clock in the morning. As far as I know, there's no way to set any times yet. So I would be careful about that. So this on the right-hand side, these are your merge fields. And you're able to use these just as you would if you were doing a mail merge with printed letters or labels, that kind of thing. So click here and you can choose a merge field that you want to drop in there. Okay, so we're going to drop in their first name. So maybe we'll do this. Hi, and now drop in their first name. Just checking in on you guys. Is there anything you need? And then you're just going to sign it. Okay. Now, you might want to create two separate plans. Maybe you have a local plan. Maybe you have an out of town plan and you might create different messages, because maybe you want to create something like a local campaign that says, "Hi, Mary, just checking in on you guys. I'm doing shopping runs this week. Is there anything you need?" Well, you wouldn't want that to go to somebody's out of town. It wouldn't make any sense, right? But this, at least this one, that should be a comma. At least this one is generic enough that it looks personal. Just checking in on you guys, or anything you need. You know, that's perfect. Or you could say, "Hi, just checking in on you guys. Is it bad where you are?" Or, you know, what's your area look like right now? What does it look like where you are right now? But again, be careful about that, because if I sent this to, I'm in Las Vegas, and if I sent this to somebody in Las Vegas, it would look like, what's like your area? They're gonna be like, "What? You live here?" You know, so just all of that, you really want to keep in mind that you want to watch how that rolls out, okay? So now we've got this one in there, and now you could do, let's do an email. So I'm gonna click send email. And the subject is in this together, okay? And then we're gonna create an email. So we're gonna put in first name, and here, hold on, let me just pause that, type that out really quick. Okay. I paused that for a second so I could type it out. So here's a quick idea. So first name, "Hey Mary, I've been thinking about everything happening in the world lately. I think we can all agree that regardless of our beliefs, the situation feels heavy and is covered with a cloud of uncertainty. While I have faith that this too shall pass, I wanted to reach out and connect with those I care about and let you know that I'm here to talk or meet for a virtual coffee anytime you would like the company. Stay well, Lori Ballen." Okay. Now, if we leave, I'm going to toggle this. Well, first of all, let me show you something. You can edit this by, like, you can make things bold, italics, you can underline. So if you wanted to, you could say something like, "I found hope and courage after watching Oprah talk about the current situation, and I wanted to share." Okay, this could be your video, it could be a video you watched, it could be whatever you want, and you could say, "I found hope and courage after watching Oprah talk about, and I wanted to share." So you could just highlight share if you wanted to, and then come up here and click link, and then just paste the video link in here. So if it's on YouTube, it's a, you know, maybe you're referring to an article, a website, a poem, anything you want that you think is of value and also not alienating at the same time, you know, then paste it here. We would never want to assume somebody's belief, their religion, their political beliefs. So I would be cautious about that. But generally, somebody like Oprah, Tony Robbins, you know, generally something like that is going to be, I would think, going to be relatively safe. So again, all you have to do is highlight wherever you want the link, come up here to the link, paste the link right there. So if you made the video, you would just change this and say, I made a 10-minute video on things that I think we can find hope in today in this economy, or I made a top 10 things you may not have thought of to do at home during this season, right? I mean, think about it. As a real estate agent, maybe you do want to give them something of value that, you know, maybe you go curate a few videos like things to do around your house to fix it up, you know, during this time that they hadn't thought of, because everybody's really looking for stuff to do. How about in case you get bored, here's a few videos you might be interested in. One is a how-to project with your kids. One is a recipe, things to make, you know, things to make with food that's always in your cupboards. And, you know, the third one is, I don't know anything. Gosh, I saw some cool videos last night on how to make a mask at home. I mean, they did everything from using bra cups and pinning straps on to, they had several different clever ideas. And I would find that valuable if I were sitting at home and I'm concerned about anything and you could send me a how-to video on how to make my own mask, that might be valuable. So to me, the text is a quick check-in. The email has something of value in it, that the hope, inspiration, how to, something along those lines, okay? Now, if you just drop these on top of each other like this, they will both go out day one. You may not want that, okay? So maybe you want to send the email first, and you're going to make that day one. And then the SMS text message, we're going to change the date. And how we're going to do that is we're going to take this set delay, and we're going to put that set delay in there. And then we can actually move it. We can move it to, there we go. So what I'm doing is I'm using these little arrows to move it up and down, and that changes where the delay happens. So the way this is right now is they get text message day one, then there's a delay. So maybe you want to change this to 3 days. And then they get the email. Okay, so that would be a two-touch. There's three steps because the delay is a step, but it's two touches, text, email. So now maybe you want to check in on them and call them. This is up to you. So you could do another delay, set delay, and call them 3 days after that if you want to. Okay, so now we have the delay. And then we're going to close these, I'm just clicking this little arrow that and it toggles it open or closed. It's easier to see the whole plan when they're closed. So then the new action is gonna be make a call. Now, what you would put here is call Mary and check in. Okay, check if there was a response to text or email. So basically what this would do now is you're going to get a task in your to-do and it's going to say call Mary and it will be linked to Mary for you to call her. Now I put a note in there, check if she had responded because I'm going to look at the contact record and see if she responded by text or she responded by email. Then I may or may not want to call her or I may want to call her based on whatever her response was. Okay. Watch the to-dos though, because the to-dos wind up in your task list and they can get very annoying and you might have too many people. So be careful about how you're going about doing that. But this particular campaign is nice and easy. It's a five-step, three-touch campaign and you can edit this, change it, build onto it. If you wanted this to keep going because you don't know how long all this is going to last and you want to check in with this person more often, you can just add a new step and add a different text now. You know, hey, you still there? Everything good? Or, you know, just checking in, you know, so we could do set delay. I'll do this one last step. So then you can see set delay and then maybe make this one for 2 weeks. And then new action, we're gonna send an SMS again. And you'll say, hey, it's Lori Ballen, just checking in with you again. All good, right? Something like that. It's gotta just sound personal and casual and not like a canned message. And then you can see if they respond. And now you've got an extra touch. Now we have a 3 week campaign. It's a 3 week smart plan. It has 7 steps and 4 touches. Now to add somebody to this, you can click on this little guy and you can pull in people by tags. You can search them by name, whatever you want to do. And the other option is you can actually go to the contact record. I'll just open anybody here. So you could actually go through and just look at them one by one and say who would apply. And then go right either right here to add a smart plan, or over here on the right you have smart plans. Add to a smart plan, and then COVID-19. Select, and boom, they instantly are on that smart plan. Okay, so that is how you can create a smart plan for what we're going through right now. A great time of crisis for checking in. Thanks for joining me today.